It's a place that's home to trade shows, sporting events, and concerts. But now the future of the Blaisdell Center is up in the air. The city is looking at multiple options. Brent Ramadna digs deeper to find out what they are. Brent?
Joe, right now there are multiple options that they're looking into, but whatever one makes the most financial sense may be the one the city goes with. Is it possible we could see maybe a new arena in the coming years here?
I guess it's possible. We're looking at sort of all the different alternatives right now, renovating existing facilities, building new facilities.
What to do with the Blaisdell Center? It's a question many have asked and a question the city tells me they're trying to figure out.
Sometimes it, you know, makes financial sense to keep it. Sometimes it makes financial sense to rebuild.
So what's the issue for the center that's been around for more than 50 years? It turns out there's more than just an aging structure that has brought up questions.
What we're certainly seeing is that the arena was sort of built as a sports facility, but today really functions more as an event facility. So that's something that we are looking at is, you know, how do we either optimize or build something new that really serves the uses that are happening there.
While a concert's always fun, the city says the facility was not laid out to function as a concert venue.
It's just not kind of meeting, you know, the needs of the people that are putting on events and therefore impacts the experience of the public.
So what should be done? Should we tear it down and build a new one, or should we just renovate it?
If they're thinking about doing anything, I would go for renovations. If the structure is sound, then I think they should use what's there.
I've seen quite a few concerts there over the last 40 years, so it's kind of an icon for me. I think we have the convention center for other things, so I think the Blaisdell serves its purpose very well.
While a final decision won't be made on what to do for some time, the city does say renovations can add up quick, the most recent work being done on the roof. So how much did that cost? Well, $500,000.
There's sort of a ever-growing list of maintenance needs at the facility because of its age, whether it's things that are simple like painting, all the way, you know, to the roof repairs.
And the city plans to meet with the community sometime in the fall to discuss further plans. In a prior meeting with the community, some ideas that came up were to add restaurants and shops to the area. And I'll be following up once we find out more information and let you know. Brent Ramadna, KHON 2 News.